We're back, wrestling fans, and regardless of what Bobby the Brain Heenan is doing, we're going to go to a match anyway that involves probably his most outrageous individual, the Benedict Arnold of the wrestling world. We're not going to do this, Bobby. Corporal Kirstner is going to be in this match against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
This is Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Imagine I have to put up with
I've
this.
Got to
we're
going to
eliminate
right
this
now.
Phone forever from prime time. We'll see to that. Let's go to ringside
right now.
Maybe
you don't
right
know
now.
Who you're talking to here, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. In the ring, from Fort Bragg, North Carolina, weighing 263 pounds, Corporal Kirstner. And his opponent...
Tremendous physique, the strength possessed by Paul Orndorff, but you certainly have to think seriously about some of the tactics that he's using.
Yes, you do, but you know, to be successful, sometimes you have to use a certain amount of
tactics. Successful, you have to double cross your best friend. Give me a break, Alfred. That's exactly what he did.
I can't really make any comment about that.
No comment. His lordship. I'm sure that we all saw a number of times on national television how he just literally hung out the champion to dry.
Well,
we know that Orndorff has a flash temper, and we know that he can easily be disturbed mentally, and I'm afraid that's what happened with Holt. Now, Orndorff thinks he has reason for that. He thinks, in fact, that Holt was the one who let him down.
Will we see a clean break? Yes. Only momentarily, I'm sure.
Yes, I'm sure, too. Because Orndorff hasn't won his matches doing things like that.
Nice weasel's eye view right over the shoulder there of Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Orndorff matching power for power there with Corporal Kirchner, forcing him back to the ropes.
Another
I can't see his face, but possibly another smile on it.
And Heenan applauding.
Oh, this is very nice, isn't it? Kirchner trying to decide what to do. I think he's completely mystified by Orndorff breaking clean on those two occasions.
Chant going out here. Weasel by this capacity crowd. And he certainly will take exception to that.
Another confrontation there of sorts against the ropes. Let's see if he breaks clean again. No. A slap around the face.
Adrenaline flowing in the body of the corporal because he didn't even acknowledge that blow, Alfred.
No, it was a slap around the face. It was a type of humiliating slap. In fact, Orndorff, I believe, wants to humiliate Kirchner. And once he's humiliated, he may make a mistake.
Definitely trying to do a sight job on the youngster.
And you know, I think he's getting through to Kirchner. Look at Kirchner. Kirchner, of course, isn't a seasoned veteran as much as Orndorff is.
Look at this now. Ah, come on, referee. The referee stepped right in there and grabbed the arm. Bobby the Brain Heenan, let me ask you this. How could you have the audacity to bring your man out here with Hulk Hogan's own personal theme song?
Oh, that's Hulk Hogan music?
Absolutely.
I don't know where you heard that from. That music was composed and written for Mr. Wonderful, and that's all I have
to
say.
That's a lie, Bobby.
It is not a lie. It's bad enough on prime time I have to take your abuse. I'm not going to do it right now here at ringside at Madison Square Garden.
Well, you want to talk to me? Pay attention to this match because the corporal has all the tools necessary to put Paul Orndorff in his place.
Yeah, that corporal is going to be back there peeling potatoes, and we're done with him. Well, and if you want to talk to me again, make an appointment.
We'll have to find out, won't we?
To launch his own attack, and quite successfully by the look of things.
They're out of shape as well as Orndorff.
In fact, they've done such a good job of psyching out the corporal that he's managed to turn the tables on there.
Well, he's got so much adrenaline flowing in his system. I don't know.
Wow, you two obviously underestimated the corporal. No comment?
There's no comment to make about Corporal Kirchner.
He drove your man right out of the ring. Man
sure,
wants to be world's champ.
Jumps up in here and kicks a man in the face with a combat boot.
We'll be right back with the exciting conclusion of this match in a moment.
You should be wearing...
We're back, fans. You know, I'll tell you something. Where do you get the right, where do you get the authority to use Hulk Hogan's music when you're coming in the ring?
That's our music. That song was written for Paul Orndorff.
Please.
The song wasn't written for Hulk Hogan. That's another thing he stole.
Let's go back to the match.
No, wait, I want to explain something
to
people here.
We're going back.
Wait a minute.
That is the top that may run out pretty quickly. It has a way of doing that.
Saps your strength. It gives you that phenomenal strength for a short period of time, and then it really drains you.
Yes. And he's going to need every ounce of strength he's got against Orndorff. I think the corporal can do something good here tonight. I'm really sure.
Standing top wrist lock by Kirchner.
Good move by Kirchner.
If Orndorff can can get the arm back there, he should be able to win that test of strength.
Well, look at the way Carson's got that on. He's got perfect leverage with that. Got it gripped right. Nice and tightly.
And Fuller Header got him out of there.
But he can't come back.
Nope. Can't believe the referee grabbed the arm.
No.
Of Corporal Kirshner earlier on.
No, and I can't believe the referee didn't admonish Orndorff just then either, because he said nothing whatsoever about that handle of hair.
Uh-oh, chant going out. Weasel here at ringside. There's 25,000 plus on hand here in Madison Square Garden, and Orndorff now starting to unload. Oh, look at that. Just rammed him face first, nose first, down into the canvas.
When Orndorff moves, it's really poetry in motion.
Suplex coming up. Well executed. Vertical job.
Super. Super. Suplex there by Mr. Wonderful. And following it up straight away. There's no hesitation with Orndorff. When he's got you in trouble, he's the complete professional. He doesn't give you a chance to recuperate.
This match been going on for some 10 minutes now, Alfred, and Orndorff has not broken a sweat yet. Show you what kind of condition he's in.
Yes, absolutely.
He'll have to be, because somewhere, someplace down the line, he's going to have to step into the ring with the world's heavyweight champion.
Well, if you can believe what he says, that was what he wants more than anything. And he's ready. There's no doubt about it. Look at him. I mean, that is perfect physical conditioning, is it not?
No question. Nobody ever questioned his conditioning, his physique, his wrestling ability,
right.
Only his manner in which he conducts himself.
He has ability, Guerrero. He really does. As you have yourself said on many occasions, he has the right mental approach.
But now he's sided with the likes of the adorable one, Adrian Adonis, Bobby the Brain Heenan. He had a big hug fest with King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd. And that's not the Paul Orndorff that I knew of.
No, he's chosen a peculiar group for his friends, but...
If that's the road he thinks he has to take, you know, to get to the top, that may be the wrong road.
It could be, but do you think that Hulk was giving him 100% consideration when they were attacking?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The Brain screaming at Orndorff, saying, watch the count, you'll get disqualified. As if that would bother him.
Yeah.
Ducks underneath, a nice clothesline. Look out, high cross body by the corporal. Orndorff shoulders down for a one count only. He's quick.
He really
is. Look at that.
Actually, the Brain is right, because Orndorff has an unblemished record here, and he wants him to keep that particular record in individual matches. And if he were disqualified, it would go down in the record books as a loss.
Oh, look at that. Clothesline him right on the steel railing.
And really, he better be careful, otherwise he will get disqualified. Just look at Orndorff.
Oh, big smile on the kisser, the Brain.
Oh, they're so happy now.
Thrilled to death. Things not looking too well here in Madison Square Garden for Corporal Kirshner, as he's been on the receiving end here for the last 4 or 5 minutes. But you got to give this youngster a lot of credit, Alfred. What he lacks in experience, he makes up for in guts.
He does indeed, and he's got a lot of courage, as you say, guts. And he has a lot of strength too, and sometimes he can dig down and pull out that victory when you least suspect it. Orndorff is not a high-risk wrestler. He doesn't make those moves from top ropes and things like that. He'll sometimes wait for his man to make a mistake and then punish him. And that's exactly what has happened in this match. The corporal made a few impetuous moves there, and Orndorff cashed in on them. And now look at him.
Irish whip in by Orndorff.
And that is why he doesn't make those high-risk moves. He did there and came unstuck with it.
Corporal managed to hook that top rope and stayed on the ropes. Orndorff came right down on the back of his head. Oh, headbutt right between the eyes by the corporal. Orndorff is reckoning and reeling right now.
He is. He doesn't exactly know
where. Atomic drop coming up, yes.
In fact, Orndorff is really hurt.
Big roundhouse right by the corporal. Where is he going? That's not one of his forte's to be up there.
What is he doing? Those boots are so dangerous. That is not his.
He's used to jumping out of planes, but I don't know what he's doing in here. Oh, look at that. Orndorff ducked right underneath that leap. comes. High vertical position.
Oh!
Good night.
Ooh, what a power driver.
Good night. Get the shower ready. This one's history. One mistake on the part of the corporal, and that's all she wrote.
Fantastic victory for Mr. Wonderful.
Gonna have a super king-size headache. Corporal Kirster, as he is the recipient of the patented power driver.
Here is your winner, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Hogan!
Hogan!
The dog getting down!
If I could expostulate just one...
I don't think even the world champion Hulk Hogan himself would have got up after that.
Let's go back, if we can, and take a look at the outstanding power driver. As that man right there, Paul Orndorff, decides to put away after making a mistake. Corporal Kirster, and imagine the impact. He not only drops him off, but
watch
he jumps
how
in
goes off.
Come on. Oh, look at that.
Twisted him as well at the same time.
Knocked him right into the middle of next week. Paul Orndorff with the easy victory with the pile driver. And now look, give an opposing demonstration to the World Heavyweight Champion's music.
Certainly wasn't, please. Certainly wasn't like Corporal Kirster should not try those high risk moves. Maybe it may have been all right in the 82nd Airborne jumping out of it, but up on that top rope, that's nowhere's land.
Corporal Kirster should take a bunch of Boy Scouts on a hike in the woods and leave them. That's simple.
Give me a break.
Yo.